Hi, this is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com. And coming out yesterday morning, we saw these. We just couldn't pass them up. These are gladiola. If you don't know about gladiolas, they're beautiful. In our climate, you have to dig them up in the fall, but they're easy to find. They're easy to actually just loosen them up a little and pull them right out. But the colors are spectacular. And the show of them is just gorgeous because there's so many on one stalk. So many, in fact, that they like to fall over, so we have them propped up against cages, tomato cages, but that's okay. I mean, it's worth it. I mean, just look at that. It's like somebody has painted there. Well, somebody did. Mother Nature. In there, you'll see all that greenery in there. Those are all new columbines that have planted themselves. I must have pulled out, thousands this spring. I mean, they were just so prolific. I left those. I don't know if I'm going to be happy that I left them or not, but maybe next spring. These are the mums that made it over the winter. This was a baby I transplanted off of another one. There's the original. We used to have a huge one here. That one, for some reason, didn't make it over the winter. It was old, very old, so maybe it was its time. And then these are some more gladiolas. These, I believe, we got either at Aldi's or the dollar store. Those I know we got from Costco. These are calla lilies. They were absolutely gorgeous. We just have one or two left. And these red are the geraniums that we wintered in the greenhouse inside. I never thought that they would actually start producing because they were so tiny when we transplanted them in there. And then this is our zinnia garden. I love zinnias, and every year this is where I plant them. I use the giant California zinnias and then the little button zinnias. I don't know what these are called, but they've decided they don't want to stay small like they're supposed to, but that's okay. So there's a variety of different shapes, which I just love. And then in the background, you see two different kinds of hibiscus. This is a hibiscus tree. It's formed into a tree. And that is a hardy hibiscus that one will die down to the ground in the fall, and you would never even know it was there except for the big stalks that are left. This is how big they are. It's almost dinner plate size. And to think that this plant can grow this height and these don't start until late in June, mid to late June, to start growing. And then they will grow like this, and they will be flowering like this almost until frost time.
Well, they last, what, one day, and then a new one pops out.
Right, they pretty much last one day, and you see all those are waiting. This one was yesterday. This one is forming its seeds for next year. What we have in front, below them then, is balloon flower. And our grandson loves to come over here and pop them. Let me see. When he pops them, they're really loud. How does he do it? Ah! I am not getting it. It doesn't seem to hurt them. There we go. Got the start of the
Sounds like cracking your knuckles.
Yes. The bees obviously love them, which is fine because they pollinate, so I'm not bothering them. They're not bothering me.
Well, it's been so dry. It's amazing. We really haven't had much water even in June, maybe the first part of June, we were still getting nice rain, but
right.
We haven't had any since for over a month.
Yes. Oh, well, almost 2 months. It's the other day we got half an inch. Some people were flooded. Our particular section got half an inch. So unfortunately, we had to water to get the gladiola and the calla lilies and these. We had to water them almost every day or every other day just to get the blooms.
And I don't see a whole lot of blooms up here except maybe on the
Oh, the honeysuckle.
The honeysuckles.
Yes, the honeysuckles that we put on
this one.
On the trellises.
Had some flowers in here.
Right, these are echinacea that we planted this year, the yellow and the orange, and that is phlox, the good stuff. This is Joe Pye weed, I believe. It has big purple heads on it. And it's growing around the honeysuckle vine. And behind, or off to the left of the pie weed, is more phlox.
And this you chopped down.
This I chopped probably in half. This was the giant fleece plant that it was taller than myself. I chopped it down. It was obviously growing way over. And now the little secondary shoots are coming up and we're getting another smaller, definitely smaller bloom, but still pretty. The other day when I was out here watering, I heard the wonderful buzzing that you know is a hummingbird. And sure enough, there was a hummingbird feeding on the honeysuckle vines. And then it would stop and it would come maybe this close to me, buzz about looking right at me, and then it would go back and feed again on the honeysuckle. So I was blessed to see that. They do like honeysuckle.
And how about the grapes?
Grapes are doing great.
Let's go over and take a peek at them.
These are the Niagaras, the yellow ones. Again, they're not, they have seeds in them, but that's okay because for our needs, we're gonna run them through the Foley mill anyway. Some of these are Catawba and Concord. I've noticed some have a black spot on their seeds, like this one. But I think it's just on the outside. It doesn't seem to be penetrating, so I'm not gonna worry about it. They're just lovely. I love seeing them hang there. We've more or less let them go this year. We haven't been trimming a whole lot. Last year we did trim, and then it was so dry that all the leaves and the grapes fell off that even sprouted. So we've been a little gentle with them this year, let them grow. And only if they got too wild did we chop off one or two branches. But hopefully we'll have a good crop.
How about the blackberries?
Oh, blackberries. Well, we didn't think we'd have any. This is the new little one that we planted, and it did produce some little blackberries on it, which dried up and shriveled, and that's fine because this is its first year planted here. We thought that we had maybe one producing vine this year, only to come out yesterday with our grandson, and we must have picked a couple of dozen of the blackberries. Now you can't tolerate eating them until they are totally black, because
about way over here these are all ready.
Oh yes they are. And when I looked at the bowl that I had the blackberries in, there was one left. Oops.
How many did you pick? A couple
probably
dozen?
Two dozen. Mm-hmm.
And some little mouth
some
found
little
them.
Mouth found them. And this is our little boy that has a very sweet tooth. These are not the sweetest of berries. They're wonderful, but you end up sometimes having to spit out actually the core. There was nothing left. He ate them all. He devoured them. So we're very happy with their progress. It's good to see it coming back after last year. We still have a couple trimmings to do. But
raspberries are really starting to take over this entire area here after they were devastated last year from that drought.
Logan was saying, Jima, I can't walk on the path anymore. Can you get some of those out of there?
Yeah, we may have to.
Yes.
Or we can tie them back.
Right. Well, we'll have to see in the spring. You know, we'll take down the old canes and we'll tie up some of the producing canes for next year and make it pickable. Otherwise, we won't be able to get in there, and the birds will have them all.
And look at your sunflowers behind you.
And my sunflowers.
They have to be 10, 11 foot tall, at least.
Our daughter came at lunch yesterday, and she said, please take my picture in front of the sunflowers, because the people at work don't believe they're this tall.
And these are small compared to the ones your dad, the seeds your dad got us when you're the Russian giant.
The Russians were 14 feet tall.
I mean, some of them are so heavy, they literally...
Well, they have fallen over.
Have fallen over.
Yes. And that doesn't stop them.
No.
They will then, if you can see them, they will then bloom sideways. Which makes it even handier for the little mice and chipmunks and birds to get to them. We've seen a lot more goldfinches these past 2 weeks, what with the liatris seeds that are available now and the sunflowers. We'll see lots of them now. Oh, gotta go in, take care of my vegetables, pick some more flowers, and get busy.
Well, we got some ketchup and some tomato juice to work on.
Yes, we do.
Well, let's get to work.
Okay.
That'll have to be another video, though.
Oh, dear. See you soon.